With everything clicking for the Tigers and the 31-0 victory, all that stood in the way for Sealy to play for a fourth straight crown was the LaGrange Leopards.
They felt like that game, they didn't have their running back Lawrence Dobbins for the first one, so they felt like they had a good chance on beating us and everything, and we were at, without our running back, Isaiah Joyner, so we had to come back and prove that we could beat them again, and we were the better team.
And Sealy always thought they were maybe a little bit better than LaGrange, and LaGrange always thought they were maybe a little bit better than Sealy, so yeah, it goes back quite a ways.
I hope you all are all at the Dome later on. We'll go out there and kick Sealy's butt.
Backs the Tigers by total commitment on Friday nights. The stands are full, the town is excited, every customer I wait on, especially today. Every question I have answered is about Tiger football, not about account balances.
Y'all gonna come out and watch us tonight?
Yeah!
We've done it once, we'll do it again. Y'all just come out there.
The Tigers' offense was in high gear from the opening kickoff, controlling the ball for a 17-play, 80-yard run.
Across the 40, the 45, cuts back inside, now outside, across the 45 from the 1-yard line for the Sealy Tigers. Pitch comes around, into the end zone, touchdown.
First drive of the LaGrange game, that's ball control offense, you know, for us. I thought it was probably one of the better drives we've had this year, maybe the best drive we've had this year. I think, you know, as I mentioned to Coach Mills, we turned the clock on LaGrange. LaGrange was always that one that wanted to pound it out 3, 4, 5 yards at a time, you know, and try to break the big one and keep the ball for 8 minutes. We turned the clock on them, we went ahead and we marched on down the field. I think we set a precedent by that.
But all that work went down the drain in one play.
Still on his feet, across the 40, the 45, coming to the near sideline, and he's going to be gold. Touchdown LaGrange, Lawrence Dobbins, 70-yard touchdown.
We were mad, we were real mad at what happened, you know, because, you know, all week we had planned on shutting him out. That was a big part of our defensive strategy. We were going to control him. And we were disappointed in what we did. Everybody was frustrated, you know. I think that was the worst. I think, you know, we don't point fingers at each other, but I think people actually, you know, some of them were like, you know, why didn't so-and-so do this or whatever.
Things got worse when starting quarterback Robbie Bozeman went down.
Well, at that point, I didn't think, I thought it was just a sprained knee or I twisted it bad or something. I didn't know the injury was this bad or anything.
Like, once again, we had to step it up for a player that was hurt and do the best we could. Just know that we'd come off the field giving 110%.
They're going to sweep it around to the left side. Safety! Tycon is unloaded in the end zone. High for LaGrange from their own 23. Hand off to Dobbins around the left side, and he is smothered. Here comes Gunn. Gunn pitches it back. Caught in the backfield. Down at the 20-yard line.
Backup Trey Moore stepped it up and kept the Tigers close.
It's a 40-yard field goal attempt. The foot into the ball, and it is good. It hits the right post. Ricochets through the upright.
But after Dobbins broke another long run to give the Leopards a 14-11 lead in the fourth quarter, doubt started creeping into the Tigers' minds.
I was scared. I didn't know what was going to happen. I just knew that no matter what, how it turned out or whatever, everybody was going to do their best and give it the best shot. And I knew that just from knowing the team.
I told the defense, I said, defense, if y'all guys could just hold them at least one play, we'll find a way to put it in there. And when Robbie came back, that's when defense seen that Robbie had enough heart to play. Defense picked it up, and we ended up getting us another point.
Both Bosman back in as quarterback. Bosman pitches it back, coming around the near side. On his feet, Kelvin Palmer, across the 50, the 45, the 30, the 20, cuts back in on his feet, the 10, 5, touchdown, Kelvin Palmer! 67-yard touchdown run!
That was Robbie Bozeman's heart, you know, that made that decision for Robbie to go back into the game with us down 14-11. That was his heart, you know, speaking. He steps up to Coach Mills and he says, "Coach, I can do it. I can go in. Let's go in. Let's do it. You know, I'm going to do it." He steps in the huddle. He tells the kids, "We're going to do it right here. You know, we're down 14-11, and we're going to do it. We're going to come back and win this thing." And he tells Tarver to follow me. I'll take care of Dobbins. And that's what he did. So you could say he's a man of his word.
Gets the snap. Comes to the near side. And nobody followed him. Ty Gunn. Fourth and one from the LaGrange 6. Hits back to Tarver. Tarver comes around the left side. Into the end zone. Touchdown! The Steely Tigers.
Keep it up. We're going back to state, baby. You got to keep it up, though. Don't let down, baby. Keep striking. Keep striking.
Unbelievable effort. I don't know how you did it. You came together, a total team effort, survived a lot of things that there's nothing we could do about, and you kept your daubers up, and you kept plugging. That's a sign of a champion, baby. And guess what? We're going to play for the state championship.
The late rally gave the Tigers a 24-14 win and a chance at making history against Commerce.